Is Odin a Viking god?
Yeah. He's a
Norse god.
In the Norse pantheon.
Odin!
Did you hear that episode of Bad Travel Podcast where Derek talks about the ritual called Blood Eagle? Like the Vikings do?
I know about that.
Okay. Blood Eagle?
Really,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
He like very slowly explains what a Blood Eagle is to Kevin. It's
from
really
like Midsummer, the Blood Eagle.
They don't do it in...
Yeah, they Blood Eagle a guy. He goes in... She goes in the barn and that guy's been Blood Eagled.
Oh. Yeah.
You're just not making the connection. They don't... I mean, they don't call it out, but that's what it is.
Yeah, right.
What it's supposed to
what
be.
What is Blood Eagle?
It's where... Okay.
I don't remember what happened.
You get, like, flayed.
You
your skin from your back, it's, like, pulled.
Wait, but you...
Oh, yeah, that guy.
Yeah.
He got...
You have to keep the person alive.
He got,
like,
legal.
Yeah, you're... That's... Yeah, because he's alive.
So you, like...
In the movie.
You, like, cut... You, like, get an axe.
I'm just gonna...
You, like, get...
This isn't part of the podcast. I'm just gonna...
You get an axe. And you don't want them to choke. You don't want them to choke,
no,
so you... So you pull the lungs out, and you kind of hold them over. I don't know why that works, but apparently it does.
Vomit cast.
Oh, yeah.
You hold the two lungs, like, over them. That's kind of, like... I think that's kind of what makes the wings, and their heart is, like, beating inside. And I think you just let them bleed out after that. I think you might take their
intestines
out.
So why do they do it to Vikings?
No, no. Vikings do it after they conquer a place, and, like, as a, like, an example of how brutal they are. Like, they'll have, like, one person... From that village
or
whatever.
Who gets bloody-eagled.
But I was reading on Wikipedia that...
Blood Eagle.
I was reading on Wikipedia that it might just be misinformation because the Catholics won, right?
Yeah,
so they wrote, like, about Vikings and, like, wrote about how brutal they were.
Right.
So they might be, like... I mean, it is... It's in the literature, but the literature is, like... it's, like, myth. It's not, like... real historic stuff. So
I'm sure someone got bleagled.
I'm sure somebody was like, this is a good idea, let's try it.
Alright.
But they'd have to be so good. They would have to be
let's
so
start the
good.
Cast. We can talk about this on the cast.
We are on the cast.
Oh, okay.
They would have to be so good at...
I mean, I
cut
the Blood Eagle talk in half, so it doesn't really make any sense.
Alright, well, whatever.
Let's talk about Vikings.
This was a good primer... For what's happening.
Primer.
What's going to happen on this episode?
This is a primer for...
This episode's called Blood Eagle.
Stanlon, how about you introduce the podcast?
Hi. We are Mind Mode.
Thank you. What's your name?
My name is Stanlon.
Hey, this is Matthew. Put my phone down. I'm on the podcast now.
Hi,
we're coming
is...
to you.
This is Michael. I'm also on the cast today.
Only today.
Yeah, this is the first
special
day I'm
guest.
On here.
Is this today only? If you're listening now, Michael's on it. If you listen to it tomorrow, Michael's not going to be on it. So be careful.
Sorry, it's been
look
so long
as good as the day I met you.
Episode.
I forget just why I left you. I was
insane.
Like, you've been off tech?
Yeah, I've been off
stay
tech.
Unplugged.
Yeah.
Play that Blink 182 song. I'll be beat to death in Tucson. Okay. Break to a heart, move to the city in a broke down car. And 4 years, no car. Now I'm looking pretty in a hotel bar. And I can't stop.
So, baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford. Bite that tattoo on your shoulder. Pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your room. And I can blow that we ain't never getting older.
He's like teched out.
Yeah,
if you've ever seen RoboCop, that's kind of what Michael looks like at this point.
Do y'all have any
he's Murphy?
Do y'all have any biohacks?
Yeah, No.
Yeah, I do. I got a I got a magnet put in my fingertip.
Okay.
Which is very useful. Very common. That's a sort of a beginner biohack.
Yeah.
But then I also got this...
it's kind of a noob hack.
I got this thing implanted in the middle of my chest. It's held on by three piercings. And what it does is, if I'm facing true north, it'll buzz. So I always know which direction I'm facing. And actually, it's very infected.
Oh, no.
It looks disgusting.
But does it work? And up
here, let me show you guys. What does this look like?
Oh, God!
So is that... So I'm probably going to get
that... Where'd you get that done? Ben Taub?
No, I went to Peace Tattoos.
Okay.
They started doing wearables?
Ben Taub does wearables.
They weren't getting enough tattoo requests.
I got a couple of biohacks.
And hey, if you're out there, if you're thinking about getting a tattoo, be sure you go to a hospital to get it done. Don't mess around.
I replaced my hands with a steering wheel.
With one wheel?
Yeah. So that when I get in my car, I can just put my hands in my...
It's like how people...
You put your hands in your pocket.
My hands are the steering wheel.
Yeah.
I never have to put my hands on the wheel.
You know how people have, like, steel-toed boots?
Yeah.
I just have steel toes.
You got the steel toes.
Yeah.
So if you drop a cinder block on them, you're good.
That's also, like, I've jammed my toe on, like, door jams and whatnot.
Mm.
I don't even notice. My freaking foot goes through the door.
Yeah.
Also,
easy.
You know how, like, what are those called? Like, women will get in, like, a contraceptive implant?
Yeah.
I got
in their arm?
Yeah.
That's real.
Yeah.
None of that stuff is up there.
Well, it slowly lets the, like, hormones or whatever out into your...
Oh.
It's like a time release thing, I think.
I got one of those.
You got one?
Yeah.
A woman's one?
No. No.
Okay. A man's
I
one.
I thought about it, but... I don't know what hormone I'm going to pick.
Yeah.
What do y'all... Hey.
I'd say human growth.
Hold on. Mind mode. Mind mode listeners. Go ahead and email us, mindmodepodcast@gmail.com, or follow us on Instagram, mindmodepodcast. Tell me what hormone I should get in my implant.
And I'm thinking human growth.
I'm thinking bull shark testosterone.
Bull shark.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So.
You got a lot of options.
Yeah. I'm probably going to go to BioCon.
You could probably switch it up.
Y'all want to go to BioCon this year?
I could go to BioCon. Did I tell you guys about my new body hack?
No.
I actually got the spider ball power up from Metroid Prime 2.
Mm. You're like rolling around so in sewers?
I can roll around on walls.
Wait, that's not useful if unless the city you know, creates...
The spider ball track. Yeah. I know, that's what the guy was telling me as I got it, and I said, look.
The city will catch up.
Spider ball tracks are going to be everywhere in 2020, so, you know, maybe I'm eating the cost now for a year, but, you know, I've never strayed away from being an early adopter.
Yeah. When, you know how, like, oil rigs, they just have that huge borehole?
Yeah.
That, like, if you drop something down there... They have to, like, shut the rig down for weeks.
Yeah.
Matthew just rolls on down there and snags whatever.
As long as they put the track down, because if I don't, I can't go anywhere.
Hey, I went to BioCon last week, and I got crazy, crazy mod.
Yeah, what's that?
So I don't know if, like, y'all have this, but I don't think anybody has it. So I lost all my teeth as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
All of them.
You lost all your teeth as a kid?
Yeah, I lost every single one of my teeth.
Are you okay?
And I was born... I was also born with no teeth.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
This is wild.
No, I'm not kidding.
You're born with no teeth?
I was born with no teeth. I was gumming it.
Really?
Yeah, is that rare?
I've never heard of that.
I've never seen a human baby, like, fresh out of the womb.
No, so it's hard to judge.
Yeah. Well, don't judge me for... Are you judging me for my
mod? No. Sorry, I didn't mean to imply that.
Okay, so I got a mod as a kid. I freaking grew all my teeth in. Then I ripped them out like a...
What?
Yeah, I ripped them out.
Why?
I wanted new ones.
But Michael, I'm looking at you now. You have a full mouth of teeth.
I have a full mouth of teeth.
Where did those come from?
I regrew them.
You're telling me you start with no teeth.
I start with no teeth.
Then you grew children's teeth.
No. I grew... Man teeth.
You grew teeth, and then you grew another set?
Then I lost more and grew another set.
Oh my god.
I bet I've got like 100 sets of teeth up there.
Yeah, what?
You want to punch me in the mouth?
Yeah, we should take a couple of those out and see what happens scientifically.
Yeah, I'm probably going to test that out tonight.
That's crazy.
Wow.
That's wild.
So you know that scene in American History X where that guy has to bite a curb and then he gets curb stomped and he loses all his teeth?
I haven't seen it.
Well, I haven't seen the movie.
That happened to me.
Can you not, don't, did you just spoil it?
It's like the beginning of the movie.
Well, okay, so
I'm just saying it'd be no big deal for me.
Yeah, but I'm saying you just spoiled a movie for me.
Well, sorry.
What? Are we a podcast that just spoils movies
willy-nilly?
Spoiler alerts. Yeah.
Mm. Y'all seen Harry Potter? I got a spoiler.
Snake kills Dumbledore.
Wow.
Snake?
A snake? Solid snake.
Snake kills Dumbledore.
Mm. The basilisk from the second one comes back?
All right.
No.
So I got... Wait. One last... I got a couple more bio mods.
Okay.
I actually got the Assassin's Creed wrist blades.
Dude, that's sick.
Put in my wrist.
Yeah?
I'm basically gonna become a full Xbox 360 video game soon.
Whoa. That's like, sick. Video game console.
Are you gonna be like...
Yeah, I can actually play the CDs.
Are you gonna be an Xbox, Xbox One... Xbox 360, a Kinect, Xbox Avatar.
Yeah.
Okay. I also found out I have another bio mod. I went and got a tattoo the other day. I went to
the hospital.
No. It was at a tattoo shop.
What, dude?
And I said, they said, "Hey, what kind of tattoo you want?" And I'm like, "Oh, I want my girlfriend. My girlfriend's name, Henna.
Uh huh.
Her name's Henna." So they're like, "Okay, so you want henna?" I'm like, "Yeah." So I got a permanent tattoo that said henna, and it just disappeared. Like, I just grew out, like, the tattoo or something like that.
Dude, you must have, like, super skin.
Yeah, I think I'm just going to get fully tatted.
Yeah, that's crazy. You got one on your face.
Yeah, I'm going to get all my teeth knocked out, and I'm going to get full bod.
For Halloween, you should just get a full tattoo of, like, something else on you.
I'm kind of bummed, though. It's going to get really expensive to maintain my ink.
Yeah, that sucks.
That's true.
But at least it's, like, a sort of a guarantee that it'll go away.
Yeah, you can, like, have a girlfriend and be like, "Michael and...
Hannah.
Whoever.
Yeah,
forever."
Hannah.
And then you know it's not forever because it'll go away.
Oh my god, that's dark.
Yeah.
What about my name? My name gonna go away?
Yeah.
So
double-edged sword.
Let me introduce this.
Also, if you were the memento guy, it wouldn't be very useful. Like, you would have no way to track.
You know, that guy's really gonna regret that when he's older. You know, he's not really thinking long term.
He's gonna wake up and be like,
"Bad, he's gonna look when he's 50. No one's gonna hire him."
One day he's gonna wake up and he's gonna say, "Why did I get this tattoo?
Yeah.
What is this?" You know what?
Just one day.
He should wear a shirt.
Yeah.
To sleep.
I bet I feel really bad.
What would that solve?
Then you wouldn't see the tattoo.
I think it's crazy that, like, he doesn't even show his tattoos, so, like, maybe you get married, maybe you, like, have kids together, mm-hmm. like, you go to bed, or you go to, like, a swimming pool, and he takes his shirt off, and whoever he's dating is gonna be like, "Oh my god, I didn't know you had tattoos, I don't know if I'm okay with
this." And he's gonna be like, "I didn't know either."
Yeah, I didn't know either.
Wait, why didn't he just get married? And then his wife could tell him, listen, okay, here's the deal."
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
That's a story about what happens when you choose isolation over community.
Yeah, you should choose community. What if he had a whole...
If he had a whole family was, like, telling him what's up.
He's like, "Yeah, grandpa."
Not a very good social support system.
Yeah.
I think probably that's what Christopher Nolan...
Probably because of all his random tattoos.
Yeah, I'd probably reminding him want to distance myself away.
Not that tattoos are wrong, but his were weird.
Wow. don't tattoo. Don't ink shame me.
What if I had a tattoo that was meant to confuse me about who I was when I woke up in the morning?
So I got a question.
What if the villains in that movie just took him to a tattoo parlor and... "Hey, cover some of these up."
Oh man,
that would be so good.
Where'd this scorpion come from? What's this for?
How does he keep figuring this out?
I don't remember if there was a villain in the movie.
I don't remember that movie at all. All I know is he would wake up and look at his tattoos.
You know the cop he like hangs out with?
No,
not really.
That was Ralphie from The Sopranos.
Oh, okay.
Also, Ralphie from The Sopranos is that guy from The Matrix, the bad guy. Splicer or something?
Oh,
Cypher.
Great, great character.
Splicer, Jack Splicer. So I got a question for you.
Yeah, hit me with
would
it.
Y'all...
Hey, welcome to Mind Mode Podcast, by the way. It's the only podcast getting issue of Mind Mode. We're talking a lot about the body today, but that don't have to be all of it. We can talk about Mind Mode, too.
We're going to be talking about Mind Mode. We're going to be talking about body. We're going to be talking about everything you want to hear.
Hey, whoa. Slow down, guys. Sorry.
Sorry.
I think we, like...
Hey, so what are we going to talk about today? All right. So scale of 1 to 10.
Uh-huh.
Or would y'all describe yourselves as...
I'm doing a scale of 1 to 13.
Ethical people?
Ethical.
Do you have a strong moral compass?
I'm a 10 out of 10. Well, I got this... I actually got... My other bio mod is a strong moral compass that vibrates whenever I'm making decisions.
I got a moral compass implanted.
I'd say I'm around a 7.
But yeah,
7.
What are morally questionable things sometimes?
I'd say without...
But knowingly. But is that worse?
I guess it's fine, because you're honest with yourself.
You're really... The fact that you're so confused about it means you can work on the compass a little bit. You should instantly know.
So I'm not going to ask... I'd rate myself maybe like a strong 3.
Okay.
I'd say...
Yeah, I agree.
Pretty awful.
I agree.
I would say my moral compass is about an 8.6 best new moral compass.
Okay. Is that what your biohack told you, or is that like a guesstimate?
Well, actually, so when I originally went in to get my moral compass evaluated, I got a very low score, about 3.7. But then years later, in retrospect, they said, actually, this was a pretty good moral compass all along, 8.6. Best
new, compass.
Best reissued seen. Compass.
I don't want to ask what the worst thing y'all have done, because that may be an incriminating question.
Yeah,
yes, it will
what's
be.
The best thing that you've done?
The best thing that I've
the
done.
The best thing you've ever
thing.
Done. The best.
Like, morally the best.
Morally
not
the
like
best.
Not like the most fun.
Yeah.
Got out of bed.
Pretty good.
By myself.
That's like a 9 out of 10.
So what are the ethics of that? How is that an ethical dilemma?
You have to be willing to get out of bed.
But, okay, Salem, look, I asked as a joke because I was going to give Salem the opportunity to tell the story, but since he's being modest, what he specifically means is the time he was laying on a bed, there was a pressure pad, and basically what was happening was when he would lay on the bed, he was getting an IV drip of dopamine. He was in a permanent blissful state, but when he got out of the bed, the machine that was feeding innocent people into a wood chipper actually turned off. So when he finally got out of the bed, that was actually a very good act for him to do.
Good.
It felt good.
It turned the wood chipper
I never
off.
Looked back after that.
Selfless of you.
I never counted how many people went to that wood chipper. I don't think about it.
Yeah, don't ask any questions, you know.
What about you, Matthew? What's
the best thing I've ever done?
Most ethical thing you've done.
I'm married to the last person who didn't get wood chipped.
If you can humble brag.
And that's great.
What's something you would humble brag about on Facebook? Or like get up in the middle of church and talk about?
What's something... Bro?
Hey.
Excuse me. Hey. The best thing I've ever done ethically is probably when I just get out of when I get out of bed and put on a pair of pants.
Okay, well, two ethical gentlemen here. Probably the most ethical thing I've done is this. Found a $50 bill that fell on the ground. Actually. Let me back up.
You helped the gentleman
up. I'm telling the story wrong.
The most ethical thing. Sorry,
so I saw a $50 bill fall out of a man's pocket.
Okay.
$50 bill. And I was with some friends. And a nice old woman picked up the $50 bill. Mm-hmm. She didn't see where it came from. And she said, hey, does this belong to any of y'all? Is this your $50 bill? And my friends were very bashful. They didn't want to say it was
You were with friends?
Yeah, I was with friends and we were out on the town.
Uh-huh.
So...
You're going to want that
$50. I saved my friends from embarrassment, and I said, yeah, it's my $50. So I took the $50, and I didn't pay for my friends' drinks, but I paid for mine.
Yeah.
But you took the hit.
And some people actually paid for mine as well, but I didn't buy any drinks. So I feel like that's probably the best thing I've done.
In the grand scheme of things, that was good because if one of your friends had claimed the $50 bill instead of you,
yeah,
their karma score in the grand scheme of the universe would have gone way down.
Their moral compass would have been off the charts.
So you kind of took the hit for them.
And I saved that guy walking away some time. He didn't have to turn around and be like, oh,
time is money.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
So we got some ethical gentlemen on these couches. I've got a problem for us.
Okay.
So how about you pass one of these to Stanlin?
Yeah, let's pass this along. I'm already seeing through the paper what this is. So we've got a full 8.5 by 11 depiction of the trolley problem.
Did you show? Is this your drawing?
No.
Okay.
This is
my motors. Printed three of these.
I got more.
We need visuals. We need visuals.
Okay. So I'm looking. So
this is an emotional.
So wait. Let me preface this. If you're in the car, or if you're at home on a computer, go ahead and Google images trolley problem, so you know what we're talking about.
Okay, so this is a depiction of a trolley train that's moving towards a split in the tracks.
Yeah.
Here's the dilemma. On one set of tracks, there are five people, and the trolley's headed for this one. However, there's a frowning man standing at a lever who can choose to pull the lever and divert the trolley onto another set of tracks that only has one man. Right? That's what it is.
So, Stanlin, why don't you give us... let's sit, ruminate a little bit. Okay. And this is a big dilemma. I gotta take some time. Stanlin's ready.
So what are you going to do?
Stanlin.
I am going to pull the lever.
You're going to pull the lever.
Yeah.
Right.
Fuck him.
Wow. Let's walk through.
I don't like this guy. Like, I like the Which other guy? Five guys.
Oh, you don't like
Which
the guy?
This guy. So, the frowny face guy.
Uh-huh.
And the guy on the single tracks have a bad history.
So he wants to...
Like, this guy stole this guy's girlfriend.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
So
it's a bad person.
It's a bad guy.
Okay.
The other five guys
it's okay to kill bad people.
Are in the same church choir as
they're singing.
The lover.
They're singing to the heavens.
And so it's an easy decision.
Can I tell you what I would do in this situation?
Okay.
I'm not going to pull the lever.
Mm-hmm.
The trolley's going to run down these five people. But you want to know why?
Right.
Very specific reason. If you look closely in the reflection of the trolley glass, you can see there's actually a lunk alarm on the wall.
Oh.
And these five people in unison screaming with their church choir is creating too much noise, setting off the lunk alarm. However, if the trolley runs these five over, the lunk alarm won't go off. And what you don't know about this is the lunk alarm is actually wired up to an automatic rifle that's pointed at an even larger field of people. So technically, that's the best thing you can do.
Well, two very ethically apt answers.
You just got to keep the eyes open.
So I got a little creative, and I decided to give some alternative takes.
Okay.
On the trolley problem.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So exhibit A, I think the first solution is, we don't know what's going on with the guy in the trolley.
Okay, so in this drawing, Michael has put a kind of a crazy frowning man in the trolley, and there's no lever or anyone outside.
Wait, so there's no choice.
So you dip. You leave.
What is this?
Okay, so
describe what this means.
you get in the trolley.
Oh, so this guy is getting in the trolley so he can feel the weight of the five people underneath him.
No, this is... You know what I would call this scenario? This is the ecologically friendly solution. Because you're removing five people who are going to have a terrible carbon... Look, these five, they probably fly private jets.
Yeah.
They're probably riding motorcycles.
Yeah.
The second guy from the right, he's probably rolling coal on a daily basis. And they all smoke.
Yeah.
And none of them are vegan.
Yeah.
And if I'm getting on the trolley, I'm using public transportation. I'm using mass transport instead of my own.
Eating paper.
Our special guest, Odie the dog, is actually eating one of the trolley problems.
Love so he's this. Already, Let's he's cut made that a decision.
Out, yeah.
So this is the eco-friendly solution, and honestly, we gotta support that. That's,
yeah.
That's a
good one. So that's solution. An ethical.
That's a good one.
That's probably that's good ethics. And
that's probably
if you're dumb enough to lay down.
Yeah.
Lay down with your buddies, relax on the tracks.
What are these outfits these guys are wearing, like these striped outfits?
Hold on,
They're
hold
tied
on.
Tied to the tracks.
All right, so another alternative take.
Uh-huh.
Put the other guy on the track with five people.
Yeah. If you tie the
but
first
don't,
guy.
You don't pull the lever.
So you're moving the guy to the track that's going to get run over.
Yeah. Okay. And then you kill all of them. Yeah.
Why is that?
That's fair.
Yeah.
Well, wait. No, because you're not pulling the lever, so it wasn't your fault at all.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so no problem.
There's just a maniacal trolley driver, and you just stumbled upon this. I don't even know why this guy's frowning.
But why? Okay, yeah. So.
Wait, yeah, but wouldn't you just pull the lever?
No.
It's not you don't want to be. You don't
want
to make a decision.
You might strain your arm and have to go to the hospital. Yeah. And a hospital.
What if
bills?
The alarm goes off?
Okay, and our final take. Final take. Jump in front of the freaking trolley.
Okay. Oh, and I'm smiling.
That's
Simon,
your decision, and you're happy.
So if I jump in front of the trolley with the lever that's attached to the ground, you're gonna have to post this on Instagram so you have a reference.
Do you still pull the lever?
Or what does it matter?
You're dead before anything
it's
else
not
happens.
Your, it's not your decision anymore.
But wait. But are the five people getting run over too?
Absolutely.
Okay.
You join your brothers. Wait, these are your five brothers.
Or what could happen is your body weight could slow down the trolley so much and your guts and your like bones and stuff could like get into the wheels.
Yeah, that
goal slow it down. Maybe you'd only hit like two of them before it completely stops.
I'm glad we got some good takes.
That makes a lot of sense to me.
I saw an alternative take on the trolley problem where you push a fat guy in front of the trolley.
Oh, I've heard that alternative.
I like that one.
That's fat shaming.
I mean, no,
not
I
right.
like that.
You can save a life.
But why
you can
save
five
guy?
Lives.
I said push two skinny guys in.
I have a question. I have
You're
a
right.
Wait,
what if you push five people in front? To save those five
Can
people.
Can I contribute another
take?
Dilemma?
Go for it. Mm-hmm.
So what if the five guys are actually of the famous Five Guys Burgers and Fries? How does that change your calculus here?
Well, then that opens up a restaurant for me to eat free food, because no one's going to be working there. No one can tell me to.
But then you don't get the burger.
You know
yeah,
what
but
guys
I'm
going
to make it there.
Oh,
so
you're going to your kitchen.
Yes, it's just my kitchen with all the ingredients stored.
Okay.
My kitchenal romance. And you know what's actually totally legal that no one talks about?
Weed.
If you go in a fast food restaurant after hours, you can cook all the food you want and eat it.
Oh.
For free. It's true. Yeah. My buddy Tommy was telling me about
That's a life hack. Tommy Pickles?
No, it's the different Tommy. It's Tommy from the chain gang.
I talked about this with a random gentleman at a bar a few weeks ago. Would you rather be Stew or... what's the other guy's name?
Stew Pickles.
Stew Pickles or
Drew. Would you rather be Stew or Drew Pickles?
Ethically, I'm going to have to go with
Stew.
Stew. He's an inventor. He's a creator.
Yeah.
Whereas Drew is sort of a yuppie. He's a pencil pusher.
Drew's a fucking 1%er.
Hey, okay. Here's a question. Which of the two would you rather half a beer with?
Ooh. Why would you half
Stew.
A beer?
Who would you want to half a beer with?
He's more interesting. He makes toys.
Yeah.
Stuff.
So you'd share a beer with him?
Yeah, I'd like to know.
I'd half
so you go you'd pour the beer down in a little dog bowl and lick it out with him?
Yeah.
That's what you're saying?
Yes, exactly.
I'd go to Drew's house, get him drunk, and then his wife's an ambitious go getter. She sees him a hot yuppie, smash his flaming hot wife.
Whoa, this is disgusting.
Smash that H-E-C-K out of her and make another Angelica.
That's not ethical.
Well, Michael, we were just talking about ethics.
I was just talking
about... I said I'm awful person.
Michael, I just... Okay, first of all, don't rustle this piece of confetti paper in front of the microphone.
Excuse me.
Second of all, I was just asking who you would want to half a beer with.
Yeah, well, I answered.
Michael would set up Drew and Stu to have a beer together
I want to have a beer in a dog bowl together.
Let me tell you, I wouldn't be able to stand Drew for a second. Or Stu for a
second. No, you're gonna
I would smack the H-E-C-K out of him.
You're not standing.
I think Stu is a little unstable.
You're hunched over on the floor licking the beer out of a bowl. You're not standing anything.
Trivia question. What was the Rugrats dog's name?
Pluto.
Rupert.
It was Spike.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You're right.
So, zero Stanlin, zero Matt, one Michael.
Does Goofy own Pluto, or is Pluto...
Pluto's fucking Mickey's.
Alright, whatever.
That's a good ethical question, though.
Yeah.
I can't believe Goofy was on CBD the entire Goofy movie.
What was his ratio? What was his CBD to THC ratio?
Goofy was definitely on sativa.
Yeah.
Yeah. Max was smoking that sticky ick.
You think so?
That's why I could do that sick kickflip.
He was skateboarding. Did you know he was technically the Rodney Mullen of Goof World?
Goof World. Toontown.
Toontown.
Alright. Matthew, you had something you wanted to talk about.
Yeah, I was just going to ask which current Democratic presidential candidate you would want to half a beer with.
I can go down this.
I pick Joe Biden so that he can give me shoulder rubs.
Okay, so you're going to get down on the floor and lick half a beer out of a dog bowl with Joe Biden?
I feel like Joe Biden's really personable and...
Yeah, he's a hands-on guy.
He's a very hands-on kind of guy.
He'll get in there and really get the job done.
I'd love to be cornered by Biden.
That's kind of
okay. What about Elizabeth Warren?
She seems we're moving on from Biden already.
Yeah. I'm biding my time.
You're gonna make me bide my time.
I'm just going through the options.
Okay, so
we're not zinging through them. Let's take it slow. Biden didn't.
So Joe Biden, I think if you were...
call him Joe or Joseph.
Joseph Biden, if you were to half a beer with this guy, he'd be cracking up. He'd be telling his hot rod stories.
Yeah.
He'd be telling his fishing tales.
Yeah.
And also...
Isn't he a veteran?
He's a veterinarian.
Oh.
What's the difference? What's the difference? Walk me through it.
One works at the Army, and one works at the vet store.
One of them deals with a bunch of animals, and the other one is a veterinarian.
That's one way to look at it.
The good thing about being friends with Joe Biden is he can get you out of a jam.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What if he's the one who puts you in the jam by cornering you in the Oval Office?
He can fire an official.
I'm not asking about any of this. I'm just asking which one you would half a beer with.
I'm saying the benefits.
Wait, which one? We've only talked about one.
Uh-huh.
Would you rather half a beer with Joe Biden or Drew Pickles?
I feel like Bernie Sanders doesn't drink beer.
Why?
Are we moving on to Bernie?
I need an IPA! What is this? Oh, God! There's too many hops in this! It's too thick! I don't think I can finish!
I think Bernie's a man of the people. When he gets down on his hands and knees and licks a beer out of a dog bowl, it's definitely probably something more along the lines
of a PBR,
a Youngling, a Lone Star, that class.
Yeah. He's a real Youngling, true. Dude. Hey, I really appreciated when he was playing that softball game and he just took one to the nose, the schnoz. Knocked the wind out of him. They had to take him to the hospital.
Really?
Yeah.
Bernie Sanders.
Is this real?
Yeah.
I did not hear about this.
Yeah.
This is real?
No, but he did play a softball game.
Oh.
And it was really weird. He got down in the dirt. And like, you know how most people are sliding into the bags?
Right.
He was running. He hit a frickin' He hit an Alex Bregman to left field.
Sliding into the bag?
And he slid into first base, which you're not allowed to do, and he just stayed on the ground. And he started just licking the ground. He wanted to get down in the dirt with his fellow Americans.
That's crazy.
Whoa. Yeah.
I respect that, though.
I'd have a beer with Bernie.
You'd have a beer with him?
Yeah. He seems like a more...
You get down on your hands and knees and lick a half a beer out of a dog bowl with him.
I feel like the second I walk into Bernie's pad, Bernie, I feel like he lives alone. Uh-huh. He's got like an apartment. He hasn't cleaned it in like a year.
Yeah.
And there's just a bong sitting on the table. And he's like,
I can see Bernie's
that. You want a daily
now.
You want to burn this up?
Hey. You feel the burn.
Remember like a long time ago he said he smoked once and he didn't care for it? I think that was a lie.
Yeah, I think he lied.
Yeah.
Do you see that guy? He's looking like Cheech and Chong out there.
Yeah.
His hair's all over the place. Looks like Leo from That 70s Show.
He looks crazy, man. That's wild.
Alright. What about Lizzie Harris? Is it
Elizabeth Warren?
You said Liz Harris. Liz Harris.
From Gruber?
I don't know who I
voted for. You're talking about Kamala Harris?
I don't know who I voted for.
Are you talking about Elizabeth Warren or Kamala Harris?
Well, what's wrong with that?
Look, I don't like
I combine my candidates because I don't want to vote for either
Michael,
or
Michael, not every woman candidate is the same.
No, of course not. We've got Lizzie Harris and we've got Kamala Warren.
Honestly, this might be a little controversial, but I'm not willing to discuss either of those for halving a beer because, like, I follow the Mike Pence rule where actually I won't be alone in a room together with a woman on my hands and knees licking up a bowl of beer out of a dog bowl if it's not my wife.
Yeah. It's understandable.
So I think we should skip these.
No.
What about Mayor Pete, though?
Listen, I feel like Kamala... she would like finish the whole glass. Like I could have a beer with her.
She seems
But you could have Elizabeth Warren. Have to drink
Elizabeth
it.
Warren strikes me as that kind of person that's like, oh, I got a haterade, but I don't really want to finish it. This goze isn't for me.
You think
and
she's
they take
the
like
of,
a few sips and then they leave you?
She would kind of she would think she knew what she wanted and she would get the wrong thing on accident.
And then
not like it.
She leaves. She just goes to the food truck at the bar.
Yeah.
And doesn't even order anything. She just talks to the guy behind the truck the whole time, even though I'm the one that took her out. So thanks, Lizzie.
Michael got too real there.
Sorry.
I think he dredged up some old.
Yeah.
Old memories.
Michael and Elizabeth Warren's past.
You know, neither of them speak Spanish like our boy.
Like Mayor Pete. Oh, Beto.
Like our boy. Beto.
Oh, Roberto.
Roberto.
Excuse me.
Is it Beto?
Excuse me. It's Beto.
Yeah. So would you half a beer with him?
How do you say voting in Spanish?
Sufrar.
Sufrar?
Is that right?
I don't think that's right.
No, I made something up.
Oh, that's a word.
I could look it up on my phone. But my phone's all the way over there. Are you looking it up?
Yeah. It's Votar.
Votar. Let me just say, no estoy votando para Beto O'Rourke.
Okay. Okay, so this is not anything related
to the
topic.
Sorry,
do
you need me to translate that?
Yeah, I said, would you half a beer with him?
Well, that's what I said in Spanish. So, sorry, I know it's been a while since you've taken
The problem with halving a beer with Beto is he tried to convince me to get rid of my automatic assault rifle.
Yeah. See,
and I don't want to have that conversation.
I would have Beto...
Some things, it would be a little awkward, I think.
Like, he feels like just because we're having a beer that he can try and convince me to get rid of my automatic weapon.
I feel like he would judge my biohacks.
Yeah, Michael's got like a Gatling gun on his hand.
Yeah, I got a freaking,
yeah.
I got an Assassin's Creed pistol loaded into my arm. I'm kind of like a taxi driver out on the streets. I feel like I would bring Beto over to my house and I would 3D print him my hazy IPA that I've been coming up with, and he would just be like, ugh, this is what you made? So, yeah, I don't think it would go well with Beto.
Honestly, I mean, I pretty much agree. I think when you're comfortable enough that you're gonna half a beer with a guy, you're going to get down on your hands and knees, lick up a beer out of a dog bowl with somebody, you're a certain comfort level, but even that's not enough to discuss if I really am planning on getting rid of my huge collection of 50 caliber rifles, yeah. rocket launchers.
I got a silenced pistol with the Punisher decal on it.
Yeah, I'm not willing to get rid of it yet.
I got a freaking MAC-10 with Deadpool on it.
Yeah.
And I bring that bad boy everywhere I go.
You keep that thing on you.
Let me tell you something let me run something by you, okay? Yeah. So breweries, they're usually like dog friendly, right?
Yeah.
And they lay
You're
out...
You're thinking a lot about breweries.
They usually have dog
Which
bowls
laid out. Which makes sense
because
we're talking about halving a beer.
It's true.
Uh-huh.
Halving a beer, right?
Yeah.
Oh, is that not a natural connection?
No, it makes perfect sense. I'm gone on a long trail here.
Connect the dots for me.
So beer comes from a brewery, and the dog bowl is what we're talking about, halfing a beer out of.
Yeah, I did not do well on my SAT logic.
I'm on an odyssey of the mind right now.
Yeah, I'm kind of mind-odding right now.
I'm lost.
So go on. What were you going to say?
Pete
Buttigieg?
I'm going to tell the story really quickly.
Okay.
Oh, we haven't talked about half.
Hold on, I'm not done.
Mayor Pete.
Oh, Buttigieg.
Yeah.
Buttigieg?
Well, let me say this real quick. I go to like breweries and they have a dog bowl.
Yeah.
And I'm disgusting. That's for me. Let me finish my dog bowl.
Sorry.
So I lap that dang beer up.
Yeah.
And that's the tastiest beer that they have to offer at the brewery. All right, go ahead.
I feel like Pete would.
Are we talking about Pete? Wait, can I say one last thing about Beto?
Yeah.
So I. If I'm halfing a beer with somebody, I'm on my hands and knees lapping up at a dog bowl, I'm going to come strapped up with my neener, and I don't think that Beto would like that.
Yeah.
Go ahead. So Mayor Pete.
So Pete, I think what would happen is you would go to a brewery, and you would look at all the options and be like, you pick. You can pick any of these options.
Wait, me?
I won't tell you what to pick.
Mayor Pete saying this?
This is Mayor Pete.
Uh-huh.
You get to pick.
Yeah.
That's what Pete would do.
Is that a positive or negative depiction?
I feel like I need a little bit of direction. I feel like I would prefer a recommendation.
So when you go to a brewery, you don't pick your... You...
No.
Okay.
I want a strong man to pick my beer for me.
Yeah.
This is what I want to do. I want to go to the brewery. You can't get beer anywhere else but a brewery, by the way. They don't have them at grocery stores, HEB, nothing. You go to a brewery... And I show up and I sit down and I tell Buttigieg, hey,
Buttigieg.
I tell Buttigieg.
What is that? What is his name? Buttigieg?
It's
Buttigieg. Buttigieg.
Well, I'm gonna say his name Buttigieg. How I want to say it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have a beer with him,
sorry,
I get to call him.
You're just
a
confusing
nickname.
Me because when you're saying Buttigieg, I'm thinking, that's sort of a daily check I do to see if I'm the Buddha yet. Is my Buddha check in the morning.
Am I him yet?
That's about when I wake up and pull my pants on. I do it.
Yeah.
Get out of bed.
I gotta.
It could be any moment that you become Buddha.
When I get a DM from the Dalai Lama.
Yeah.
When I get a DM from the DL, that's when I know I've made it. 0 to 100, started from the bottom. Now I'm Buddha. Anyways. So I sit down and Pete, I'm like, hey, get me what you think I want. And he goes and gets me the nastiest stout in the world.
Yeah.
And he brings it to me.
He brings you the friggin'...
And it's the worst freaking date I could go on.
Listeners, have you ever sat down with a... You ever sit down with a new stout you're trying and you get it confused with a friggin' bottle of Kiko Man hot sauce sitting next to it because it tastes about the same, looks the same too? You know what I'm talking about? I once went to a brewery and downed a whole light sodium bottle of Kiko Man because I thought it was my beer. Tasted
Kiko
so
Man.
Yeah, never done that.
Never
before.
Happened to me.
Did we go through all the candidates? Is that it?
I'd be embarrassed if there was a
Marianne Williamson. Is she still?
I don't even know who that is.
She's gone. Okay.
What about Tulsi?
Halsey?
Gabbard.
Halsey?
Who's yeah, what
that?
About Halsey? Okay, moving
don't know
on.
Gabbard.
What about Hillary?
Oh, she's
throwing her hat in the ring.
You know, I think it's her time.
Yeah.
She's earned it.
This is, yeah. She deserves a second chance.
I'm with her.
Should finally be a win for us.
At least I can keep that bumper sticker on my car for
another year. At least I can keep that tattoo on my thigh that says Hillary 2016.
Yeah, I can keep that tattoo on my shoulder that I know I can't afford. If we talk about Hillary or Halsey here, folks. I hate it when I get a tattoo that I know I can't afford.
So who are we...
I'm at the hospital, I'm getting my tattoo done. I know I can't afford that.
Do they make you pay for a tattoo before you can afford it or after? Not before,
It's a hospital. They just hit you with all kinds of charges.
Oh yeah.
Sometimes
why we need universal health care so that I can get my free tattoos.
I go in for a routine procedure. I'm going to get a small butterfly tattoo on my little big toe.
You're charging an arm and a leg.
And next thing I know, I'm getting it amputated.
Do you have to pay for the tattoo before you get it?
I just...
Well, that's what I'm talking about.
Sorry, I was checking the time on the dang cat.
That's okay, that's okay.
The D-A-N-G cat. Sorry, I didn't mean to curse.
Here's what I'll say.
Here's what you'll say.
When I'm getting a tattoo... I'll say,
so baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your...
I'll know if I can afford it or not when I'm getting the tattoo.
Yeah?
I can feel it.
Would you be willing to get like half or like 73% of a tattoo if you're like, oh, I can't get this anymore?
On my shoulder?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Hey.
You know what I get really mad about is when I,
Hey. Yeah? Go ahead, sorry.
I'm pissed.
I'm just introducing my...
I'm so freaking I-R-A-T-E right now.
Michael is losing it. Michael's, like, steam is coming out of his...
Do they call it the IRA because they're irate?
Are we talking about the Irish...
Resistance
Republican Army?
Republican Army?
Republican Army, sorry.
Wow, Stalin thought it was the Resistance.
Wow.
My bad.
Michael's really pissed.
Okay.
He's steam. He's irate now.
Yeah.
IRA. More like the IRS. That got me friggin' irate.
What about... You know what?
I'm looking like the irate gamer when it comes to tax season. I'm looking like the angry video game nerd at that point in time.
Do you know my dad's... Actually, I'm not gonna say that. Would y'all get a tattoo at this point?
Yes.
Yeah, why not?
What would you get?
Tomorrow.
A skeleton.
Okay.
So I know I can't afford
So, podcast logo. I like it.
Yes.
Represent.
I'm representing my mode.
Okay. Good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Glad to hear.
I just get the ley lines.
The what?
Just sort of the ley lines of the situation on my back.
Let me walk you through the ink. What's some more tattoo lingo?
Ink. Juice.
Yeah, if I'm gonna get juiced up.
You're talking stick and pokes.
I'm gonna call them permajuice.
Yeah.
That don't go away.
Yeah.
I'm probably going to get
stitched.
I'm probably going to get a...
Getting stitched up. Can we make up some more tattoo lingo? I think we need to expand the...
Yeah.
I'm going to get a Samoan design on my shoulder.
Yeah, like Maori.
Call out to my shoulder. I saw the movie Moana.
Uh-huh.
And I felt like...
Samoan. Is that what's in the movie?
Isn't he?
Are they Samoan?
That movie's for children.
Isn't
he
Moana?
What? Excuse me? I said Samoan because it stars The Rock, and the Rock is Samoan, right?
Yeah, so if I was getting a tattoo...
I didn't get to say.
How many cartons of eggs does The Rock eat?
He eats, like, doesn't he eat, like, 30 tilapia a day?
Oh, yeah, that's it. He only eats tilapia.
Go ahead, Michael, sorry. Go ahead. That's a bottom
feeder. So I would get... Disgusting. I feel a lot of kinship between The Rock and I.
Yeah,
he's, like, big and muscular, so am I.
Yeah.
I can, like... I make a lot of money. I got like 20 million followers on Instagram. I'm a golden god.
Yeah.
So I'm going to get a Samoan tattoo. It's probably going to say like Frozen.
The Rock.
Or.
Frozen.
What's the Samoan language? What's the dialect?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, Samoan. I'm going to get a Japanese, some Japanese characters.
Yeah.
And it's going to say, I was doing just fine until I met you.
When you
but
say
now I'm okay.
When you say Japanese characters, you mean like Luffy D. Monkey?
Yeah.
Naruto.
I'm probably gonna get Naruto and under that and say
and Pikachu.
You're looking good in a hotel bar. Four years no call. Can't stop.
I think I'm just gonna get anime girls all over my arms and legs.
That's kind of culturally appropriative, but
when I get
you should get something a little more respectful like mind tattoos.
When I get a tattoo, I'm gonna call it getting ripped up. I'm gonna say I got ripped up this weekend, but everyone's gonna be like, "Whoa, are you okay?" And I meant, yeah, I just meant I got my tattoo. That's kind of our lingo. It's kind of what we call it.
Yeah,
I feel like we should come up with our own lingo.
That is what we already said we were doing.
Well, not just specific to tattoos.
Oh, like everything.
Yeah. Oh, this can be a sort of a mind mode call sign.
Yeah,
this is how you can signal to the geeks and gamers in the crowd that you're.
Yeah. So hey, if you call yourself a brainiac, you're the only ones who are gonna get the
riff.
The riffs I'm throwing around.
Yeah. Any other lingo we have that
I got specific? Spiced.
You got spiced. You walk into work. You walk into work with a doctor's note. You say to your boss, "Hey, I got spiced." What does that mean?
It's just like getting prescription like Tylenol.
Nice.
When you get when you go to the doctor,
when you go to the doctor
and they tell you you need to take Tylenol, that's called getting spiced.
Wait,
God, I just got spiced,
dude. People say they go to like a cryo chamber. You know,
cry.
People are constantly talking.
They're like
about
weeping.
That's
there.
When I go to the ice shop and I get some new necklaces, some new chains.
Hey, just got.
I have this little thing.
I just got cryogenically frozen.
Hey, you just got cryogenically frozen.
Whenever.
And it hurts so bad, I got spiced.
If I have a female friend and I tell them, hey, if you're ever in trouble, CBD. Doesn't mean what you think.
Talking ball torture.
Call by the phone.
Call Big Daddy. Talking about me.
You say that to just a random platonic acquaintance.
A female friend, yes.
You say call Big Daddy.
Yeah. Why don't you say it to me?
They know who they're talking about.
Yeah, why can't I call you Big Daddy?
That's kind of weird.
Why don't you say it to us?
Wow. That sounds like a kind of a Joe Biden move.
If I just got spiced, I might CBD. I got one.
Okay.
Bring it on.
So when you, if you walk down the street and you see someone and they look exactly like you and they're wearing the same clothes as you and you kind of mirror each other's motions unconsciously and you pass by them and you walk by and you turn around and look back and they're not there anymore, that's called, getting Jack Skellingtoned. So if you're ever in that specific scenario, you can say, "I just got Jack Skellingtoned," and everyone else who listens to this podcast knows exactly what you mean.
It happens more than you think.
When you're like at a bar,
yeah.
And I mean, I don't smoke, but if I did, I don't smoke cigarettes. And somebody asked me for a cigarette. I'd be like, sure, and I'd pull out my pack of cigarettes and give me one, and then they finish it.
Yeah.
And then I'd hand them another cigarette and say, "Hey, are you into the chain smokers?"
Is this lingo or
I don't know,
it was just a joke.
Yeah,
this is kind of a Shaggy Dog story. You kind of told us a Shaggy Dog story.
Okay, so that's
Sorry, go ahead.
I watched You Were Never Really Here.
Is this recommendation?
I think it's time to wrap it up.
Oh my
Michael's
god.
Michael's done.
Y'all want
to? We haven't even gotten to the main topic I had planned.
You had a topic?
Well, I guess we'll save it for next time.
I thought it was the... Whatever.
More work for next time. I mean, less work for me to do.
It's true.
Go ahead, say it.
I don't want to go first.
You want to talk about your little movie?
What y'all think of? I watched You're Never Really Here again, and I liked it, but it wasn't as impressive the second time through.
I only watched it once.
I watched it once.
It was good. It wasn't as intense.
He got less intense.
Yeah, I watched a good YouTube essay on it.
Oh yeah,
it talks about like how he has PTSD but it's never really
here.
There.
It's never explored or like directly addressed. Mm-hmm. It's like all told thematically. Yeah. It's a cool movie. I recommend that movie.
I think that's how I would want to kill somebody.
Excuse me?
Sorry, never mind.
When did this come up?
Another recommendation.
You said that like you've been thinking about it. I mean, I guess the trolley problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess we're all murderers.
Yeah, if I was going to kill somebody... Well, no, sorry, I was just about to spoil the movie. Never mind. Go ahead.
I recommend drumming. Banging on a drum set. Feels really good.
Yeah,
Michael, I'm drumming a lot.
You gotta hit it
I'm freaking good now. Yeah. I'm like Flea. I'm like Chad Smith. I'm like...
Yeah.
Anthony Kiedis on that freaking
Michael's
kit.
Like T-Rex. He just wants to bang on the drum all day.
Hell yeah.
Is that a T-Rex song?
I don't know.
I don't know who T-Rex is.
Bang your head.
Where's your head at? Come on.
Nothing.
Keep the circle going.
Nope.
Any recommendations, Matthew?
Recommending what?
Recommendations.
Oh. What have I been enjoying lately? What have I been slow sipping like a smooth mimosa on Sunday morning? Nothing for brunch like an egg over toast. Toad in the hole.
You're off your gourd today.
I could take one. Here's what I recommend. If you're ever in a time machine, happened upon it, you're dialing in a date. Here's the range I'll give you. After The Hobbit, Denny's, your destination. You're getting the Hobbit whole breakfast. This Hobbit menu was a...
Wasn't that like was a 6 flash years ago?
I thought the Hobbit menu was at IHOP.
It was at Denny's.
Oh, we went to Denny's?
Yeah.
Oh.
Here's what I'm going to say.
Say it.
Time passes by like bubbles on the stream. You blink and you can miss a whole lifetime of new experiences. Your candle can go out at any second. And 1 second is all it takes for you to hit that button in the time machine to go back to the Hobbit whole breakfast. Eat the Hobbit whole. Drink the classic. I don't know what drinks they had. But then also if you're still in the time machine, you can go to when they had like a partnership with like Fountains of Wayne or like Blink-182 for like punk rock after midnight theme meals, and you can get those.
That's awesome.
What were those called?
Punk rock pancakes.
I would call it sort of a whisper in a rainstorm. Others may never hear it, but you know that's there, and you know it's gone forever. Tears in rain.
Salen, what's your recommendation?
Is this T-Rex? Who's T-Rex?
T-Rex?
Who's that?
He made the song Bang on the Drum, I think. Oh. Or the band did. I said he, like it's a T-Rex.
Sounds like it could be one guy.
You have a recommendation, Stanlin?
I think John Frusciante played in T-Rex for a little bit.
Can't stop thinking about a bongo. Flip-flop, sipping on the bongo.
I kind of don't have anything.
He did not play in the band.
I guess so. Oh! I mean, well, I don't really want to talk about The Lighthouse because you guys haven't seen it.
But you want to recommend it.
I would recommend it. It's good. It's a good movie. Been watching Legion, which is actually pretty good.
The superhero show.
I hate superhero stuff, if I haven't said it on the podcast before, but this is good.
So you're
different.
Oh, it's a Todd Rundgren song. I'm sorry. It's not T-Rex.
Rundgren?
Todd Rundgren.
Rungren.
I got another piece of lingo.
Rungren.
When you go to the gym and you get juicy, you get swole, you could call it get it veiny. I got veiny the other day.
I'm getting ripped up and veiny this weekend.
Yeah. Nobody even knows.
You could say I got varicose.
I got
varicose this weekend. I got ripped up and varicose.
Brute.
I got spice.
I got spice, dude.
Dude, when I go in the sauna after a hard workout, you know how like you get steamy?
Yeah.
You're like a dumpling. So like when I go in the sauna, I'm like, oh, I'm getting,
I took a dump.
I'm getting linged. I'm getting linged after this workout.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, I'm taking I'm
Or I'm taking a dump.
Is what taking Taylor a dump. Tries to say. Is that used for anything else?
No. I think we can use that.
Please email us mindmodepodcast@gmail.com. Like, subscribe, go to Instagram, go to YouTube, send us a letter.
Subscribe come up to with our Patreon, $5 a month.
$500 a year.
Send us an email and tell us who you would, which presidential Democratic candidate you would like to half a beer with. And let me specify here, when I say half a beer, I mean you're splitting a can of beer in half, you're pouring half of it into a dog bowl, half of it into a different one. You're getting down, you're lapping it up off the damn floor on your hands and knees. Good night and good luck, everyone. We love you. We want your
give us your bio
shoulder, pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your roommate.